This is Ryan from the Stewardship Committee. We wanted to show you how easy it is to give electronically to the church. You can do that by going to the website abumc.gives. And in here, you can enter in the amounts that you'd like to give to the church. You can do that to the general fund. You can add money for the coin offering, our monthly coin mission. You can also add money for special contributions. So on Sundays, when we raise extra money for a specific event, and you put money in a specific folder or write in the memo line of a check what it's for, you can do that here also. You just enter in the amount and then specify what it is. Or there's ongoing designated funds that are available. So today we're just going to give to the general fund. We'll say we're going to give $35. You can then choose the frequency. If you want this to be a one-time gift, you can just select one time. You can also hit weekly or bi-weekly or whatever you'd like. So if we said weekly, we can say we wanted to give $35 a week, start today, and then you could select an end date when you would like that ongoing contribution to stop. Or we just say we'll just do a one-time gift. We then hit continue. On this next page, it asks you for your information. You can just select or enter in your information. So say that's me. We'd enter in a credit card. And the billing address. You can set up a password if you wanted to have a secure login that would save your information. And then you'd say, I'm not a robot. In here, you just select what it asks you to do. So here it says select all the squares that have a traffic light in them. So all these have parts of a traffic light. We then hit verify, and it realizes I'm not a robot, and then we'd hit process. That would process the credit card and set up the one-time or recurring giving to the church.
Thank you. Welcome to worship at Algoma Boulevard United Methodist Church. I'm Pastor Cathy Weigand, and I am so glad you're here with us today. You are welcome here, always, just the way you are. If you'd like more information about Algoma Boulevard, you can find us on the web at abumc.org. Lots of information about what's coming up, what's going on, and who we are. Want to make sure you know that we have Christmas Eve worship services planned. We'll be online, Facebook Live, at 5 o'clock on Christmas Eve, and then that will be available anytime after 6 o'clock for you to view as well. And we'll be here in the parking lot doing drive-in worship at 7:30 and 8:30 p.m. Christmas Eve. We hope to see you with us. As we worship today, kids, I want you to get a piece of paper and something to draw or color with. I want you to make a picture of one of your favorite people. I'm thinking like a friend or a cousin, someone you really like to hang out with, someone that you know well and you consider one of the best people in your life. So paper, pencil, colors, whatever you need, draw a picture of whatever person you think of when you think of your best friends. Today we continue on in our time of waiting in the season of Advent. It is hope for light to enter the world. Through this time we've been focused on the lyrics to the song, O Holy Night. And this week, we take time to focus ourselves on the words, truly, he taught us to love one another. We'll be doing that as we look at the scriptures of the pregnancies of Elizabeth and Mary. This week, we'll be lighting our fourth Advent candle, bringing light one candle at a time into the world. Shepherds at the time of our story in Scripture were generally not accepted. They lived on the edges of town. They weren't trusted. They weren't valued. They weren't loved or much cared for. And yet it was the angel of the Lord that appeared to them. They received the good news of the birth of the Christ child first, and they were asked to share it. The love that Jesus brought into the world was for everyone and continues to be for everyone. His birth reminds us of the many ways that love can be shared and the difference that it can make in the lives of so many people. When we share the love that Jesus taught us about, we move toward his law of love and his gospel of peace for everyone.
Hello, we're the Condor Lineweber family. I'm Kaylee.
I'm Jim.
I'm Lisa.
I'm Paula.
And our scripture reading tonight is Luke 2, 8 through 14. And there were shepherds living out in the field nearby, keeping watch over their flocks at night. An angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid. I bring you good news that will cause great joy for all the people. Today, in the town of David, a Savior has been born to you. He is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign to you. You will find a baby wrapped in cloths and lying in a manger." Suddenly, a great company of the heavenly hosts appeared with the angel, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth, peace to those on whom his favor rests."
In the company of angels, we come today.
We open our lives to the presence of the heavenly hosts.
We sing praises to God.
Praise and glory to our God forever and ever.
We light this angel's candle with praise.
Joining hands with those of every sphere who share our love for you.
Let's pray. God of heaven and earth, eternity and time, angels, saints, and we who struggle on life's way, thank you for Christmas. A day when the heavens opened, the angels sang, and a baby is born. Truly that baby taught us to love one another. His law is love and his gospel is peace, but not just for him, for everyone. The angels watched over that baby, sleeping with the family that would love him on earth. For the kingdom on earth sometimes seems so far from the kingdom of heaven. And yet you bridged that gap then, and you bridge it now. Jesus was born to teach love and peace, to bring hope and joy. He is Emmanuel, God with us. Praise be to God. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
The candles have been lit. So come, joy, lighten our spirits. Come, hope, lift us from despair. Come, peace, and ease our frantic worry. Come, love, shine in all that we do. Come, Jesus, be born in us. Come, Lord, set us free. Come, God, rule in our hearts and teach us to sing with joy. As we sing our opening song this morning, please share any joys or concerns that we can be praying about this week for you. Also, please take time to prepare your morning tithes and offerings. As we approach the end of the year, please consider any additional gifts that you can be making to the church. They make such a difference in all that we do. Our opening song today is the Christmas carol, O Come, All Ye Faithful.
Oh,
Okay, kids, how is your picture going? If you're not done with it yet, don't worry about it. You can keep working on it as long as you want. Hopefully, you've got a start on a drawing or something beautiful that reminds you of one of the favorite people in your life. Like I said before, a friend, a cousin, someone that you love to hang out with. This is my friend, Christy. This is a picture of Christy and our families together on vacation. I'm sorry I didn't draw the picture. I ran out of time to do it, but I knew I could get this fairly quickly. Now, Christy and I have been friends for a very long time. And we love to do things together, and we stay in touch with each other, and we see each other throughout the year, even though we live pretty far away from each other. I miss her a lot right now. And I'm wondering if you miss your friend, your person on your picture. In the scripture reading today and throughout all of worship today, we're going to be talking about how Jesus taught us to love one another. He talked about sharing with each other and taking care of each other. He invited people to join in, and he welcomed everyone. It didn't matter who you were, Jesus would invite you to be part of it. He stood up for people. He healed people. He did a really good job of loving people. And he taught us to love one another. And because he taught us that, it means he really actually wants us to do that. So if you think about your person in your picture, what could you do this week to let them know that you love them and that you care about them? Could you have a video chat with them or play an online game with them? Could you send them an email or a note or a card? Could you find some way to let them know you're thinking about them and that you care about them? And maybe when you're talking or sending them a note, you could think about something you could do together next time you see each other. It's exciting to make plans like that. Your person is important to you, and my person is important to me. And we love each other. And we can find more ways to let the important people in our lives know that we love them. But we can do even more than that. We can do like Jesus did and reach out to other people too. Certainly to our favorites, but also others that might need to know about love and kindness and care. People who might need a friend. People who might need support and care and something fun in their lives. We can do these things. So this week, reach out to the person in your picture and think about a new way you can share love with them. And maybe together you could talk about how you could do something to reach out to someone else to share God's love and to share God's joy with someone new. We all have ways that we can learn from Jesus when he taught us how to love one another. And we can start with our favorite people because that's pretty easy. But let's keep trying to live like Jesus asked us to live and to love. Let's pray. God, help us love each other. We can do better with friends and family. And then we can practice sharing love with people in our community who might be alone or need help. God, help us pay attention to the people around us and teach us how to love everyone. Amen. As we come to a time of prayer, we know that for some people, this season is so full of joy and beautiful memories, the lights and the excitement and all of the hope that goes with the celebration of Christmas. And we also know that for some people, this season is difficult. So we find the balance. We lift up the joy and the pain. We celebrate with one another. We care for one another. And we find new ways to share love because we know that in this season, that's the reminder in our lives. So as we lift up our joys and our concerns today, we know and we commit ourselves again to praying for each other, to taking the time to reach out and to love and to lift each other up. We're grateful for the ways you share your prayers with each other, and we're grateful for all of the ways you take care of each other. Let's be together in a time of prayer. Almighty God, true hope of all the earth, when you sent your child into the world, you taught us to love each other. You taught us about a law of love and a gospel of peace for everyone. Prepare in each of us a warm and welcoming place where we can receive the King of creation with gladness and kindness and faithfulness. Help us expand our love so much that we might meet all people with that same kind of love. Create in us a quiet place of light and peace, where we can keep the holidays as the holy days that we celebrate. Help us reach out to any who struggle in the season. For them we ask gifts that only you can give. To those who are mourning, to whom the sounds of merrymaking are hard to hear, give a deepened awareness of your arms around them and peaceful certainty that your other arm is around the loved one they are missing. To those who are dying, let the peace of your coming surround and sustain them as the time of their leaving draws near. Reassure their faithful hearts of your undying love and life. To those whose hearts are breaking with sorrow and worry, reveal how your coming brings power and peace for just such times as these. To those who are sick, and God, there are so many who are sick, open a window of insight so they can glimpse the healing you plan for your whole creation. Give them patience and endurance and the care that they need to get through. For those who are out of work and out of their minds with worry about it, go before them, God, to open a path through their troubles that they can follow you into bright future. For those separated from loved ones, let their hearts experience the spiritual joy of concentrating their thoughts and worship on you, who so loved the world that you gave your Son. God, in the toughest moments of our lives, help us see your love through the people who gather around us and lift us up, to hold us tight and to give us strength. And help us be that love in the lives of others, in the name and in the example of Jesus, who taught us to love and who taught us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen. Our next Christmas carol today is Lo, How a Rose E'er Blooming. Let's sing together.
Oh,
Before I read our scripture for today, I want to give you a quick update of where we're at in the story so you have some sense of what's going on. Elizabeth unexpectedly found herself pregnant later in her life. She had long since given up hope of having children. In her sixth month of her pregnancy, her relative Mary found out that she was also pregnant. And that brings us to our text today from the Gospel of Luke, chapter 1, verses 39 to 45. At that time, Mary got ready and hurried to a town in the hill country of Judea, where she entered Zechariah's home and greeted Elizabeth. When Elizabeth heard Mary's greeting, the baby leapt in her womb. And Elizabeth was filled with the Holy Spirit. In a loud voice, she exclaimed, "Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the child that you will bear. But why am I so favored that the mother of my Lord should come to me? And as soon as the sound of your greeting reached my ears, the baby in my womb leapt for joy. Blessed is she who has believed that the Lord would fulfill his promises to her." The scripture later tells us that Mary ended up spending 3 months in Elizabeth and Zechariah's home. Why? Why did she leave her hometown and travel to a different town to be at a relative's house? And why did she stay there for so long? Mary went to visit Elizabeth and stay with family because, let's face it, she was unwed and pregnant in a time and in a culture that didn't support that at all. Her community would look at her and judge her and say that she hadn't done things in the right way. She wasn't living how society expected her to live. So she went to stay with Elizabeth to give herself some time to figure out what would be next and what her life would look like. It was amazing timing that Elizabeth happened to be pregnant too. These women loved each other, supported each other, sustained each other. If they were drawing pictures like the kids did today of who their favorite person was, they might have chosen each other. They cared deeply about each other. When things were harder for each of them than they could have imagined, when things were not necessarily how they would have planned them to be, they were still present for each other. And God was present in their love for each other. God showed up in the midst of all of that and brought joy into their lives. God celebrated their life and the support and the delight that they gave to each other. God shows up to celebrate in our lives in all kinds of ways. My friend Christy, the picture I showed of my person today, is someone we've celebrated her marriage, our kids, celebrations that have gone throughout our lives together. And I think all of us in our lives have people that we celebrate things, and we can name those moments where we've known the love and the joy of friends, but also of God, the birth of a child, the celebration of an anniversary, the success of a project that's gone well, and so many others. But God also shows up when things don't go according to plan, when things aren't how we expect them to be or want them to be, when others don't understand what's going on with us and judge us or condemn us. God shows up in our relationships that bring us life and hope, even in the tough times. In the song, "O Holy Night," the lyric is, "Truly he taught us to love one another. His law is love, and his gospel is peace." God taught us to love by sending Jesus into the world. God taught us to love by showing us the care, the love, the delight between Mary and Elizabeth, and how we can also be strength and support and joy and hope for others. As Jesus grew, he showed us how to love people who were on the edges of society, people who were left out and marginalized. He taught us to love God and to love our neighbors, being very clear that neighbors includes everyone. God teaches us love and shows us many examples. And Jesus taught us love in liberating and life-changing ways. When we love each other, we honor God. We live as disciples of Jesus Christ, and we strengthen our connection with God and with others. We see in Elizabeth and Mary that God was present to them in a challenging moment of their lives when they were present to each other. They can be such a powerful example for us in this year when so many things have not gone according to our plans. This is a year that we would not have planned, and we often haven't gotten what we wanted or expected or what we would have chosen. It is a year that is harder than we could ever imagine. But God is with us, and God is in the connections that we make with one another. These are the things that help us get through the tough times. Right now, we're thinking and praying and making choices about what comes next. How do we celebrate Christmas in a new way? How do we support and love each other in a difficult time? How do we reach out to neighbors that we've not yet met so that we can be their support and strength and love in the lives of others? I think oftentimes when we read the Christmas story and celebrate it, we often have a sweet image in our minds of a young couple and some nice farm animals, some shepherds. All is calm. All is bright. But when we look more closely at the story, we see a young woman leaving town for some months after discovering a pregnancy. We see Joseph planning to leave her, but being talked into sticking it out by an angel who appears to him in a dream. We watch a young pregnant couple travel for the census and discover that there is no place to stay. I'm guessing that laboring with your first child in a stable is neither calm nor bright. It's not a pretty story of when everything goes right. It's a gritty story about how God shows up in the hardest, most challenging moments in life. No matter how unpredictable, how unmanageable, and how unimaginable our messes are, God is present. Elizabeth was beyond childbearing age. She had given up hope of having children, and yet she was pregnant. Imagine her overwhelming feelings of joy, and then maybe some anxiety. She would have a child at last to love and to care for. And she would also have a place in society that labeled her barren and had cast her aside. But wait, suddenly Elizabeth was going to take on this new thing, which was both exhilarating and exhausting. Motherhood can be hard. It is so exhausting and demanding. Could she do it? How would she manage? Was she up to it? We have to imagine that while her joy was high, she would have been anxious too. And then her relative Mary showed up, like Elizabeth, also pregnant. Her not quite yet husband Joseph was confused and upset. Mary was young and poor. Probably she had been anticipating setting up a household with Joseph, establishing herself in her new role as a wife, and then maybe, hopefully, becoming a mother. Instead, an angel appeared to her, and her whole life changed. Her whole plan changed in the knowledge of the identity of the baby that she carried. Both Elizabeth and Mary responded to the revelations and situations by opening up themselves to the possibilities of how God was working in their lives. And today, when these two come together in our gospel reading, we have a better idea, a stronger sense of the outpouring of joy and praise for God's startling presence in their lives. It wasn't perfect. It wasn't beautiful. It wasn't planned. It wasn't calm. God showed up in the mess of all of it. Jesus was born in a stable, a small, cramped, congested, messy place. A newborn baby probably was a little out of place amidst the dusty animals, the mucky straw, sneaking vermin, the spilled grain, the usual smells and sounds and sights that are found in a stable. But this mess is the message of Christmas. There is no stable. There is no place in our world or in our lives that is too poor, too remote, too outcast, too other, too messy, that God cannot be found and formed in us in that place. The beauty in the story is in the way that God loves us and teaches us how to love one another, to show up for each other. Christmas isn't about getting everything right, although we really, really wish we could. It's not about necessarily the decorations or the presents, the food or the memories, or having it all go just as we expect it to go. It's truly about finding God in the midst of the mess of life, finding strength and support and being strength and support for one another as we live in the mess. Especially in this season when it is such a weird year and things can't be how we want them to be, when the weary world is still weary and longing for a reason to rejoice, these two women give us a powerful example of what it takes to love one another, to connect with each other, and to know God's presence in the midst of any mess we might face. I pray that each one of us can find and know God in the hard moments of our lives, and that we can find new ways to reach out and to share that love with others. This is truly what Jesus taught when he taught us how to love one another. Amen.
Holy night, the stars are brightly shining. It is the night of our dear Savior's birth. Long lay the world in sin and error pining, till he appeared and the soul felt his worth. The thrill of hope, the weary world rejoices, for yonder breaks a new and glorious morn. Voices, oh, now.
As we prepare to celebrate the coming holy night, hear these words of blessing. May the stars be extra bright. May the song of the angels be clear. May the love of God hold you today. And may God bring joy to you and to all who are near. Amen. I hope that you'll join us in praise and celebration on Christmas Eve. And until then, let's sing together our closing Christmas carol, What Child Is This?